Good morning. Good morning. Merry Christmas Eve to all of you. This is my first time doing sort of Christmas Eve in the morning. Isn't it wondrous to be here in the daytime? I want to welcome all of you here in person. I want to welcome you joining us on our stream to our service this day. In your bulletin, you do have a list of announcements. I'm not going to go over them, but they are there for you. You also have a blank piece of paper, but hold on, that'll be later on in the service. We're going to do something together. I do just want to make special note of the flowers that are up here on the podium with the flame and cross. Those are to celebrate Jim and Pat Lobbs. This is their 60th anniversary. And so we want to celebrate that with them. So I do welcome all of you this day. This is our family service. So if it seems a little chaotic, we designed it that way. If things don't turn out, we meant it. All right. Our kids have worked incredibly hard, and let me just say this. They have put their hearts into praising God. And so they are here to make a joyful noise. And we're going to be doing that with a lot of different things. We've got bells and boom whackers and their voices, and as well as our readings. So I do welcome all of you, and let us come, let the Holy Spirit break forth and be with us on this day that we celebrate the birth of Jesus. We're going to begin with our call to worship. It's responsive. I'll invite you to stand. I invite you to respond with the underlined portion. I want to invite up Deli and Quinn and Sumner and Mary and Noah. They're going to be helping us with our call to worship. You're here, Mary. Right here. You're as hope is. And you're here.
Testing.
Yes.
I invite you to respond with the underlying portion.
Hopies.
Pieces.
Sure. Wait. Oh. We gotta let them respond. Do hope is.
Hopies.
Trusting that there is light even in the dark.
Pieces.
The wolf lying down with the lamb.
Joyous.
Contagious sounds of hallelujah.
Love is.
Unquenchable, never-ending, born in a manger, here today.
Christmas is.
And so on this day, we do celebrate and worship God as we light the candle of hope, as we remember the birth of the Prince of Peace, as we celebrate the one who is the foundation of our joy, and as we remember his amazing love for us, as we come to celebrate the birth of Jesus as we light our Christ candle. So let us begin with song. Verses 1, 2, 3, and 6 of hymn 234, O Come All Ye Faithful. You guys want to sing up?
Oh,
fresh appearing. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Christ the Lord.
You may be seated. Thank you, kids. Our first lesson this morning is John 1, 6 through 8, 19 to 23. Let me invite up Isabel and Emily and Cynthia. Come on up. First lesson. This one here.
A man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. This is the testimony given by John when the Jews sent priests and Levites from Jerusalem to ask him,
"Who are you?"
He confessed and did not deny it, but confessed,
"I am not the Messiah."
And they asked him,
"What then? Are you Elijah?"
"I am not."
"Are you the prophet?"
"No."
Then they said to him,
"Who are you? Let us have an answer for those who sent us. What do you say about yourself?"
"I am the voice of one crying out in the wilderness, make straight that way of the Lord."
As the prophet Isaiah said,
Thank you, ladies. Let me invite up Izzy and Sam. This is our kinesthetic prayer of confession, which means we're going to do some movement, and they're going to be leading us in this movement that we will be doing.
People of God, the prayer of confession today will be a kinesthetic prayer, which means we will use both our hearts and our bodies to pray. I invite you to join me in prayer, responding with actions as you are prompted. Let us pray. Friends, on the night of Jesus' birth, Mary and Joseph struggled to find a place to lay their heads.
If you, like the people of Bethlehem, have ever withheld hospitality to those within reach, please cross your arms.
On the night of Jesus' birth, the wise men traveled long and far, trying to get to Jesus.
If you have ever let your faith take a passive, backseat position in your life, failing to take the steps necessary to deepen your faith, please bow your head.
Joseph showed radical grace to Mary at a time when many would have shunned her in their disbelief.
If you have ever failed to show grace to yourself or another, please close your eyes.
Family of God, this is what sin feels like, being cut off from one another, in the dark, disconnected, and alone. However, we worship a redeeming God who pursues us even in our absence.
Therefore, if you, like the shepherds, have ever looked for God's love in this world, open your eyes.
If you, like Mary, have ever treasured your neighbor as a gift from God, raise your head.
If you, like Joseph, have ever forgiven yourself or someone else, uncross your arms and grab the hand next to you.
And if your head is still bowed, your eyes still closed, or your arms still crossed, open and uncross them, for you are forgiven by the grace of God.
Friends, this is what the kingdom of God feels like. Heads up, eyes open, connected, forgiven, and known. Thanks be to God for a love like that. Amen.
Amen.
Our second lesson is from Luke 1, 29 to 38. Let me invite up Aaron and Quinn and Myra.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent to God in the town of Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said,
"Greetings, favored one. The Lord is with you."
But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her,
"Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end."
Mary said to the angel,
"How can this be, since I am a virgin?"
The angel said to her,
"The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth in her old age has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God."
Then Mary said,
"Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word."
Then the angel departed from her.
Our third lesson today is from Luke 2, 1 through 7. I want to invite up John. We'll see. There he is.
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
You may remain seated and let us join in singing Away in a Manger.
Kids to come forward and share a time with me. So come on up. We got lots of room here left. So just have a seat. And while you're sitting, come on up and have a seat. I'm so glad to see you all. And I welcome those that are joining us online as well. All right, you in there? Okay, good. All right, so today is a very special day, right? And why is today so special? Christmas Eve? Anybody else? Because Jesus was born?
Jesus will have his birthday tomorrow.
Jesus will have his birthday tomorrow. And everybody's going to be happy.
And I have one more.
Okay, what's your one more?
Is that we're doing a Christmas service thingy?
Yes, we're doing a Christmas service thingy. Any more? We good? Okay, thanks for sharing, everyone. Telly, did you want to say something? Oh, okay. All right, so you are right. You are right, all of you. Today is a very special day, and because on this day, a long, long time ago, Jesus was born. And on the night that Jesus was born, some very lucky people were able to go and meet baby Jesus. So do you know who came and to meet baby Jesus?
When?
The wise men.
The shepherds.
Yeah. Sheep. Yes, absolutely. They went along with the shepherds, I expect. You know? The farm animals were there. Yeah. Maybe some angels. All right. Yes, yes. So I have a question that I've been thinking about, but I need you to use your imaginations on this one, okay? So if you had been there the night that Jesus was born, what would you have said to Jesus? What if you had said to baby Jesus? Happy birthday! Welcome to the world! First impressions matter, so, you know, look good. Suit and tie, if possible.
I'd say, dear Lord, welcome to the world.
Dear Lord, welcome to the world. Yes, I love that. Thank you all for sharing. All right, now, continue to use your imagination. So if you could give baby Jesus a gift, what would you give him? A book. That. Some kind of origami, yeah? Oh, baby Jesus? Yeah.
A bottle of glimmering sand.
A bottle of glimmering sand. Ooh, cool gift. Some clothes, yeah. Any others? Some water. Water's always good. And food. All those things that we need. Okay. And to make him happy. So you'd give that gift of happiness. Thank you. Those are all some really great answers. Thank you so much. You're also smart and caring. So you know what? One of the best gifts that we can give Jesus is to love one another. Okay? Yeah, to love one another. So as a Christmas gift to Jesus today, I am going to invite you all to go back to your families, your people here, and to do two things. Okay, hold on. Don't go yet. Give them a hug and thank them. Okay, say thank you and give them a hug. But don't go yet. Okay? Because you know why? We all need each other, and your gratitude will also make God's heart happy. So before you do that, I'm going to invite you to pray with me. I'm going to invite everybody here to pray along, okay? So this is a repeat after me or an echo prayer. Everybody ready? Okay. Loving God, thank you for coming into this world. We love you very much. And tonight, or today, excuse me, we celebrate you and say thank you. Thank you for your love. And all God's people say amen. Thank you all so much. Now you can go back and give those hugs and thank yous. Oh, and y'all, thank you, Deli. You want to go ahead since you saw that there? We're adding our baby Jesus to our nativity scene. So thank you so much.
Thank you, kids. Go back and say I love you to those with you. Our fourth lesson today, I'll invite up Aaron and Quinn and Sumner. This is also our reading with shepherds and with angels. So anybody who's dressed like a shepherd or an angel or an animal, I invite you to come up. And you could be up here too. So, we got to get that low. So shepherds and angels and animals, come on up. in our readers with Quinn and Aaron and Sumner. There we are, right here. And the rest of you go up behind there.
Meow.
In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them,
"Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy, for all the people to you is born this day. In the city of David, a Savior who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger."
And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying,
"Let us go now to Bethlehem and see." Sorry.
"Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors."
When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another,
"Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us."
So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger.
All right. We're going to join singing "What Child Is This?" We're going to invite up our good news singers, our joyful choristers. So this is everybody. So the kids and the youth are going to sing verse 1. And then you're going to come in for verse 2 and verse 3.
Thank you.
Thank you. Our fifth lesson is from Matthew 2, 1 through 12. Let me invite up Madeline and Christelle and Emily and Noah.
In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judah, wise ones from the east came to Jerusalem, asking,
"Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observe his start as the rising and have come to pay him homage."
When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all of Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was born. They told him,
"In Bethlehem of Judea."
Then Herod secretly called the wise people and sent them to Bethlehem, saying,
"Go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found him, bring me the word so that I may also go and pay him homage."
When the wise ones had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was.
When they saw the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed and joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary his mother, and they kneeled down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chest, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And have been warned him in a dream not to return to Herod. They left for their own country by another route.
All right, good news singers. Come on up. Their special music today is We Three Kings. That they are doing on these, you might have noticed up here, which are called Boomwhackers. And that actually is the name because it's printed right on it. If we didn't make that up. We Three Kings with our good news singers. Thank you. I am quite certain you've never heard music set to boomwhackers. And now you have. What a joy. We come now to offer ourselves. The Magi, who we just heard the reading, and we had the song We Three Kings, brought gold and frankincense and myrrh to the Christ child, the finest gifts for a king. However, they also brought themselves, physically putting their bodies at the edge of the manger. On this day, I invite us to follow in the footsteps as we offer ourselves, our prayers, our financial gifts. In a moment, you're going to hear some music play. Mary's going to play a carol. And when you do, in your bulletin, there's a blank sheet of paper like this. There's pencils in the pews, or you might have a pen. I want to invite you to write down a prayer on the slip of paper. This is just for you. You're not going to share it. You don't have to show your neighbor. We're not going to have you read it aloud or put it anywhere. This is a prayer. Maybe you have a prayer for yourself or for a loved one or for a neighbor, for the world around us. I just want you to write a prayer on the slip of paper. You can, besides offering your prayer, which is what we're offering in this time, I invite you to also offer your Christmas offerings. We won't be passing the plate in this service, but there is a plate out as you exit the sanctuary, out into our gathering area. Your Christmas offerings, I invite you to give out there, outside the sanctuary. Friends, we come on this day to offer ourselves, our whole selves, to God in this moment. And we do so by offering our prayers and by offering our blessings. So let us come to give our time, our talent, our treasures, as we offer our gifts, our whole hearts, our whole selves to Jesus Christ. So Mary's going to play, and we are going to be in prayer. God of hope and peace and love and joy, you've given us everything we have, from the magic of this wondrous season around us, the tall, strong evergreens, to the smell of home cooking and the sound of alleluias as we offer our praise to you. You have given us everything, and yet when you were born into this world, all they gave you was a manger and hay. Thus, God of life, we pray, take and use all that we offer, our prayers, our gifts. Use them so that they may strengthen, so that we may be strengthened like the roots of an evergreen, that we might feel the warmth of your light and hear the sound of Alleluia. In deep gratitude for all our blessings, we pray in Christ's name. Amen. Our sixth lesson today from John 1, 1 through 14. I want to invite up Sam and Izzy and Isabel and Cynthia and Emily for our sixth lesson today, which I'll just say as they're coming up, this is also our confirmation class, so we're pretty proud of them. So, all right, everybody.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God.
He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being.
What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it.
There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light.
The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him.
He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of the man, but of God.
And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
Amen.
Thank you.
I want to invite you to take out that prayer that you did. Hold that. Open our hearts. Let us be in prayer together. O God of starlight, today is such a joyful day, a time of candlelight and sweet traditions and alleluias as we praise you with word and song. And it is a holy time of children dreaming, joy to the world, and stories of old. However, we also know that for many, they are cold, they are lonely, they are hungry. In other words, this is a day like other days. Thus, God of angel choruses, in the midst of our joy and hope that we celebrate this morning, be with the parts of us who are carrying grief and anger and fear and doubt. Be with those who we hold in our hearts who are spending their Christmas in a hospital, and with the doctors and the nurses working valiantly to keep them alive and bring healing. Be with those spending their Christmas alone. May we see them. May we know them. May we welcome them into our lives. Be with the families who cannot afford to celebrate Christmas. Grant them joy and peace on this night as we also see them. Be with those who have suffered loss this year, for whom Christmas has transformed into a painful reminder of what once was. O God of starlight, today is a joyful day for many, and we are beyond grateful for your gift of God made flesh, Jesus born in a manger for us. However, in the midst of our joy, help us to remember and love the parts of your creation that struggle to sing Alleluia on this day. And now, echoing the words of your Son, God made flesh, we pray together the words that Jesus taught us, this guiding prayer, as we pray together with one heart and one voice. Would you pray with me, please? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Family of God, we hear in Scripture, to you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord, and that God is stronger than any darkness. So believe this good news. God is here. God is love, and God loves each of you. As a reminder of that love, we are now going to sing Silent Night. So I'll invite you to stand with your candles. For the young ones who got a bag, in those bags is a glow stick. I want you to take the glow stick and crack it, If you were a bigger person, you have a candle. If you want a glow stick, we can get you one too. But you have a candle. You have a candle. And so I invite us in this time. I want to invite our Good News Singers to come up. Good News Singers? Oh, I'm sorry. Gotta lower it. All right. They are going to be singing verse 1. And when they're done, you all will come in with verse 2 through 4. But as soon as they start singing, I'm going to start lighting the candles, and I want to invite you to pass the light. And then our ushers, if I can have them just turn off all of the lights.
Testing 1, 2, 3.
And thank you for the sound check. That's wonderful.
No.
So let us come to celebrate this love born to us as this light shining in our hearts and into our world. Let us join in Silent Night. So come to us, Lord Jesus, be born in our hearts, our minds, our lives. Again, may the light of your life be kindled in us all and lead us to the shining truth of God with us, God for us, God in us, May we go in love, hope, joy, and peace. Amen. So, our Good News Singers, they're going to be playing the bells here with Joy to the World. And they're going to play Joy to the World. Mary's going to play a little intro, and then we're all going to sing Joy to the World. And then the kids are going to grab these stars. They're going to hand them out to all the other kids all throughout the sanctuary. And that is our recessional this day, as we are taking this light, the light of our candles, but the light of our stars, and being the light for the world around us. So let us join in Joy to the World. And we'll sing after they're done playing, and Mary will play an intro. Sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sound.